The Hadley Institute for the Blind and Visually Impaired presents iFocus, tips on using the vision accessibility features in iOS. In today's installment, we'll look at arranging apps. Hello, my name is Douglas Walker. Today, we will be checking out how to arrange our apps. Actually, when all is said and done, we will even end up creating a folder right here on our desktop. Now, arranging apps is something that's very spatially driven. So first, it's important to know how the items on our screen are laid out or how they're arranged for us. And we need to know this before we can actually begin moving them around. So if we aren't yet familiar with the layout of our desktop, we just might want to check out our beginning voiceover gestures iFocus video. It does a pretty good job of getting us familiar with exactly how items on our screen are laid out for us. Now, creating folders can be a great way of becoming more organized, and we can do this by placing apps that are similar in nature in a single folder. Creating folders can also help us to gain some space on our desktop here for additional apps if we like. Now, on our screen, we don't have any folders set up at the moment. Our apps are just laid out here for us in our rows and columns. Okay, the arrangement of your apps, of course, might look a bit different on your screen. And this is because we've already begun moving our apps around here. And we've placed our most frequently used apps on our home screen here. All right, now the first two apps in our top row here are actually GPS apps. And, you know, it might be nice to have these two apps in a single folder. So how about we just use these two apps in our top row here to create a new folder? Now, the first thing that we'll need to do is to get into editing mode. Now, this is going to allow us, of course, to begin editing the items here on our desktop. Okay, now we get into editing mode by performing single finger double tap and hold gesture. I tell you, the key here is to hold, because if we simply just single finger double tap, our item is going to be activated or, of course, launched or open. So to demonstrate how to do this, we'll first just touch one of the apps that we're going to want to edit here. And like we said, the two apps we're going to be working with here are in our very first top row here. And I don't know if we're already there, but we'll go ahead and just touch in the top left corner of our screen to make sure here. So we'll just touch in our top left corner here.
Seeing iGPS. Double tap to open. Actions available.
Great. And here is our Seeing iGPS app. So remember, to enter our edit mode, we will need to perform our single finger double tap and hold gesture. So let's do it. We'll just single finger double tap and hold, and we'll just single finger double tap and hold anywhere here.
Started editing.
Great. We heard our double tap and hold audio cue, and VoiceOver also announced that we have started editing, and that's pretty great. All right, now that we're in edit mode, we'll need to again touch the app that we want to begin arranging. So let's just touch our Seeing iGPS app again in the top left corner here. So we'll just touch it here.
Seeing iGPS is editing. Double tap to delete. Swipe up or down to select a custom action, then double tap to activate.
Great, and here we are again, and VoiceOver gave us some really great hints. We were told that our Seeing iGPS is editing. We were also told that we could just single finger double tap to delete this app. And we were also told that we have actions available to us. Now, if we aren't yet familiar with our actions, well, actions are simply additional options that are associated with the item in which we are currently encountering. And actions are really easy to interact with. All we need to do to cycle through our actions is to just flick up or flick down our screen. Now, interacting with our actions is how we will drag around the items on our screen and how we will begin creating folders here. All right, remember, We're on our Seeing Eye GPS app here in the top left corner of our screen, and this is one of the apps that we want to place in our new folder. Now, we need to think about where we're going to move it. Okay, our Nearby Explorer app is just to the right of our GPS app here, and Nearby Explorer just so happens to be our other GPS app. So our Nearby Explorer app and our Seeing Eye GPS app are the apps that we want to be in the same folder. So we will combine these two apps into one folder, and we'll begin our arranging process by using our action features. Okay, how about we just flick down to begin our arranging process? And we'll just flick down our screen.
Drag Seeing Eye GPS.
Great, and we heard VoiceOver announce Drag Seeing Eye GPS. And this is exactly what we want to do. Now, if we flick down again, VoiceOver will announce Activate Default. So we know that we could then just simply double tap to delete this item. However, we don't want to do that. We want to begin dragging or arranging our items here. So we'll just single finger double tap to select our drag action here. And we'll just double tap.
Nearby Explorer is editing.
Okay, this is great. We have actually been placed right on our Nearby Explorer app, which, of course, is just to the right of our Seeing Eye GPS app. And, you know, this just so happens to be our second app in which we're wanting to create our folder with. Okay, you've probably already guessed that we need to, again, begin flicking up and down through our actions. So let's do it. We'll just flick down, and we'll flick down.
Add to drag session.
Okay, VoiceOver announced that we can add our Nearby Explorer app to our drag session. Now, this means that we can add this app along with our Seeing Eye GPS app to both be dragged to another location. And if we like, we could add these two apps right here to a third app in a folder, which is really great. However, we aren't going to do that today, so we'll just flick down again and check out our other actions here. So we'll just flick down.
Drop Seeing Eye GPS before Nearby Explorer. Drop ready.
All right, we're told that we can drop our Seeing Eye GPS app right before our Nearby Explorer app. Now, this just so happens to be where our Seeing Eye GPS app is currently located, so it really wouldn't make much sense to do that. But anyway, we do have that option. Okay, how about we just flick down again, and we'll just flick down.
Drop Seeing Eye GPS after Nearby Explorer. Drop ready.
Okay, and here is our option to drop our Seeing Eye GPS app after our Nearby Explorer app. So this is how we'll go through rearranging our apps on our screen if we like. And as we can see, this is a pretty easy process. However, we're wanting to create a folder with these two apps, so we will just flick down again. And we'll flick down.
Create new folder with Nearby Explorer and Seeing Eye GPS. Drop ready.
Okay, now this is exactly what we want to do. We're told that we can create a new folder with our Seeing Eye GPS app and our Nearby Explorer app. And this is great. However, we do have just one more action here. So how about we continue to just flick down, and we'll check out our last action. So we'll just flick down our screen again.
Cancel drag.
Yeah, and we're told that we can cancel our drag or our arranging process here. Now, we don't want to do that, so how about we just flick back up to our folder creation option here. So we'll just flick up.
Create new folder with Nearby Explorer and Seeing Eye GPS. Drop ready.
Okay, here we are back on our folder creation option or action, and VoiceOver announced that our drop is ready. So we'll just single finger double tap to drop our apps here, and we'll create our new folder. So we'll just double tap anywhere here.
Creating navigation folder, off, null, row minus one, column minus one. Navigation folder is editing, two apps.
All right, now our new navigation folder is available right here on our desktop. Okay, so we finished creating our new folder, and we're still in edit mode, so we just need to exit our edit mode. And this is really simple to do because all we need to do is just press our home button here at the bottom of our screen to stop editing. So let's just press our home button here.
Finished editing.
Great, we heard VoiceOver announced, finish editing. How about we go ahead and just touch in the top left-hand corner of our screen to locate our new navigation folder. And so we'll just touch.
Navigation folder, two apps. Double tap to open, actions available.
Great, here's our new navigation folder. And we heard VoiceOver announce that we have two apps in our folder. And we were also told that we could single finger double tap to open it, which is super great for us, right? Okay, so now we know how to arrange our apps to create a new folder. And if we want, we're able to create even more folders. Or if we have another app that we'd like to add to our new navigation folder, we could just use our action features and we could add it right here in our new navigation folder if we like. Okay, like we mentioned earlier, it's going to take a bit of practice and a good sense of spatial awareness to become more proficient at creating and working with folders. However, creating folders is a really great way to become more organized. And I tell you, it makes our apps here just so much easier to find. Again, my name is Douglas Walker. Take care, and I'll see you next time. For more from the iFocus series, including many other topics of interest to individuals with vision loss, visit the Videos at Hadley page on the Hadley Institute for the Blind and Visually Impaired website at www.hadley.edu.